Okay, now we'll look at the muscles of deep back. These will be the erector spinae group, which are the muscles that mostly run up and down. They will be iliocostalis, longissimus, and spinalis. Those are muscles that bilaterally, if they contract on both sides, will cause extension. And the other major group of the deep back are the transversospinalis group, these muscles in blue. They are the semispinalis muscles. And they, in bilateral contractions, also cause extension. But in unilateral contractions, those muscles will cause rotation, one side causing rotation to face the opposite side. So right transversospinalis, these would be the semispinalis muscles in the transversospinalis group. Right side contracting will cause rotation of the front to the left. If we go back to our erector spinae muscles, right side contraction only will cause lateral flexion to the same side. We will also look at abdominals in this construction. We'll look at the rectus abdominis, then deeper, the external oblique, then deeper, the internal oblique. We'll skip the transversospinalis, the deepest. I'm sorry, the transversus abdominis. We'll see these as major flexors of the trunk, but the oblique muscles will cause rotation of the trunk to one side or the other.